YouTube, it's your boy, the Franchise Guy, coming back at you again with a quick episode of NHL 19 Franchise Mode featuring Philadelphia Flyers. This is going to be a full gameplay episode. It's just going to be a training episode. We're about a month and a half, like a month and a half before the trade deadline. But remember last time I did a trade episode, it was also like a month and a half before the trade deadline. There's a couple pieces I want to move from this team. I think one of them definitely trying to get the contract off is Sergei Bobrovsky. A lot of teams are interested in him, but actually Edmonton goalies, I mean, they have a franchise goalie right here. He's not quite ready yet. But I said I wanted to do a mega trade. Not just any little trade. I want to go in all the way for this trade. Let's just see who's Mr. David Wells. Third name is Dylan Wells. Mr. Dylan Wells. I mean, I feel. Let's try. Trade reject. Alright. Alright, let's find someone else. Let's add. That's some draft picks. Alright, I'm not trading this year's one. So I don't have a 2 for 2022. Let's do a 2023 2. And a 2024 2. And there it goes. That's the trade right there. Words are hard. That's the trade I like to see right there. Anthony Stolarz. Welcome to Philly. I mean, Connor McDavid, welcome to Philly. Who do I care about Anthony Stolarz? Let's go to roster moves. See who I need. NHL. The problem is goalies? Nope. Wells. Alright. Let's go to edit lines real quick. All right. Oh boy. That is a slight lock jam I have right here. All right, let's go. Let's take Konechny. I'm gonna scratch Konechny for right now. Give him to center. Goalies. Gonna put Wells in. It's not gonna stay the backup for long. Alright, boy. Let's go back and edit these lines. So apparently trading Bobrovsky makes us a hopeful. We add Connor McDavid, but we go from a playoff team to a playoff hopeful team. I'm not sure exactly how that works, but that's what happened right there. Not entirely sure how that works at all. But I want to try Drew, Voracek, David on the first line. And then we have Patrick, Kutz, and Jeff Carter. Second line, bottom two lines won't be touched at all. Bottom six is not the greatest. Not the greatest our bottom six is. Alright, go back to trading. This is just a trading episode. I'm not entirely sure how long this is going to last. I'm just trying to. Pretty much now that we got McDavid, we can clear some cap space. And I think some of that cap space is Konechny. Konechny is a top six medium, while Couturier, sure, he's older, but he is an elite. Try and just clear some more cap space without taking any cap back. A lot of teams interested. The Canadiens. Let's see, Montreal. I just want draft picks from you. Alright. So they have two firsts. Minnesota second. They're second. Let's see. Can I get Minnesota's first too? So there's this rebuild. I'm not sure how exactly I find this as a rebuilder since they do have a winning record. I mean, possibly. I don't know. They have our third for next year. Can we just take their entire draft class for next year? Possibly? Nope, I don't want that pick. Let's go. Let's take this year's third back. There. Yeah, this year's third. Fourth. Come on, there it is. Fifth. And can I take Minnesota's first? No. Come on. All right, I don't want. Try trajected. Alright, I guess that's what we're doing right now. As unfortunate, hit the button a little too quick. Who else is on our block we need clear cap for? So first, two thirds, two fourths, three fifths, a sixth, and three sevenths. Alright. Rookie goalies. I mean, medium elites, 19 at 64. I'm just trying to find someone who's not a Hopeful. Champion. I don't want someone who has, like, the greatest record, but, like, I don't know. I want someone who has, like, a slightly worse, like, a mid-round draft pick record. Jersey, let's check out New Jersey. You have a first round pick, New Jersey. Alright. What? Can I take next year's second? Third. second. If I can get one more, just come on. There it goes. I'll try seven. There we go. I'm not actually sure. I can't remember what draft picks we had at all for that. Let's go. Let's take a look. So we have New Jersey's first, our first, 3/3, 2/4, 3/5, 1/6, 4/7. All right, so we got third. So we got a second round pick next year. That's good. And a second round pick in 2023. All right, so we're getting back into, I guess, everything. We got to trade. We're gonna trade some pieces away to get some pieces. So what happens, that goalie is never gonna, we're never gonna actually probably even use that goalie ever. Like, cold stuff here is more or less trade bait, honestly. I mean, San Jose wants him. I mean, does they have any draft picks? Like a decent round draft pick? I'm looking for next year's third. I can get maybe another. Let's go. Maybe I can get one more set. Alright. So 2020, next year's third, and two sevens for this year. And there we go. Alright, let's go to roster moves. Edit lines. Boy. So, defense. And our defense is lacking a ton. Like, I don't know. I know we need to draft defense. That's kind of why I want some extra draft picks just throughout, just so I can work on defense. Because these are only two defensive prospects. And at 20 years old, at 63 and 50, they're or 55, they're probably not going to work out. I think, yeah, he's low elite, and he was drafted in the fourth round of our first year. And Mosier was drafted in the fourth round of our first year as well. So these guys were drafted, 117 and 102, 15 picks apart. So, I mean, they're not. At this rate, they're not looking like they're gonna make it, which sucks. But you know, our minor league, Ty Ronning, 29 points, 37 games. Frost, Massard, 31 points. Turbochank, 34 points. Ratcliffe is at 25. Suzuki, struggling, definitely struggling, plus minus a negative 3, 23 points, Dimitri Lisson, only at 20 points for Lisson, which is concerning. I don't care about any of these guys. Malkin, 3 points, Dadnoff, no points, and Tvashinov has 9 points. Goalies, Stolarz is 17 wins, 27 games. So he's definitely going to get caught up. I'm definitely going to switch around the goalies. Alexander Alexandronov. Only one win. That's not the worst. Scratch. Any? No one really, I guess, super good's being scratched right now. But, just to take one look. Anyone else that needs to be cleared out of contracts? So they're technically, look at that. Look, we got $12.5 million for 6 years. And I'll just, nah, can I sort? I can't sort, can I? Nope. Right there, sort. So we have 8 years for Patrick. McDavid is 6 years. Honestly, I think I'm going to switch around the line just to put words are hard. I'm going to put, what's his face? I'm going to put Couturier. There he is. Couturier back on the first line, and then put McDavid on the second line, Patrick, and Jeff Carter, just because I think that might help Patrick's development a little bit. I mean, I get cap-wise at $12.5 million for the next 3 or 6 seasons. It's not going to... You don't really want to put him on your second line, but that's what we're going to do. Best locker room chemistry is P. Maroon from Nashville. Let's take a look at Nashville and this P. Maroon guy. They have the Preds. Sort. P. Maroon is a left winger, top 9. Alright, Patrick. Hey, former Flyer, too. 6-round draft pick. Oh boy, 3 years, $2 million. I mean, he'll do whatever, he lacks loyalty, which I don't personally care about. I mean, oh boy. That's a big cap hit just to... Nah, it's not even close right there. I wouldn't know what to trade for him. Because at $2 million, I want to trade someone who's at least making $3 or $4 million. Just to dump salary slightly, but I don't have anyone that. Like, outside of like Joe Thornton and not even Hague, I paid that money. I said Thornton, and I guess Jeff Carter. God rest Jeff Carter, so wherever he is. Yeah, I have no idea what Jeff Carter is. Unless you get him to like one of these. There he is, and Jeff Carter's $5 million up, and Joe Thornton's $4 million. Those are like big contracts we have, really, and I'm just gonna sit on that contract for one more year just to have Carter finish out his career at the Flyers at, let's be 38 years old. Like, our cap hit only took a slight hit, just saw it right there. We're at like 6.0 something, now at 5.9. I feel like it's pretty good. Pretty good right there to come out pretty much on top. We got a bunch of draft picks. We got probably one of the best players in hockey right now, Connor McDavid. But for this episode, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. If you guys missed an episode, make sure you guys check the playlist down below. Until then, YouTube, make sure you guys, peace out, rock on, stay classy, I guess.